I'm Maria, and today I'm going to show you some easy ways to install Docker on Ubuntu. Docker is a popular tool for developing and deploying software in packages known as containers. Ubuntu is one of the most popular Linux distributions and is an operating system that is well supported by Docker. Installing Docker on Ubuntu creates an ideal platform for your development projects using lightweight virtual machines that share Ubuntu's operating system kernel. This video tutorial will get you started by explaining four ways to make that happen. But before we get started, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. You can install the latest Docker release on these versions of Ubuntu and on these supported architectures. There are several ways you can install Docker, and your choice will depend on the functionality you need and your preferred approach to package management. Docker on Linux was traditionally terminal only. A functioning installation comprises Docker Engine, a daemon that runs your containers and the Docker command line interface for interacting with the daemon. Docker Desktop is an alternative way to use Docker. Historically only available on Windows and Mac, it was launched for Linux in May 2022. Docker Desktop on Ubuntu requires an AMD 64 processor in either Ubuntu 2110 or 2204. It provides a graphical interface for managing your containers and integrated Kubernetes cluster and support for third-party extensions. Docker Desktop also gives you the Docker and Docker Compose CLIs. Docker Desktop is different than Docker Engine in that it uses a virtual machine to run your containers, which is why Docker Desktop is required for Windows and macOS users. Although it's possible to use both flavors side by side on Ubuntu, you might find conflicts between Docker CLI versions. It's best to pick one and stick to it. Choose Docker Engine if you're comfortable in your terminal and want the best support and performance. Docker Desktop's VM makes it slightly heavier, but is the best choice if you want an integrated UI or plan on using Kubernetes. Docker Engine is the standard way to run Docker on Ubuntu. It works with all supported versions and environments, from a local Ubuntu desktop machine to your Ubuntu server cloud host. Make sure you're running an Ubuntu release that's 18.04 or newer before you continue. First, let's look at the most commonly used option. Docker publishes packages to its own apt repository. You'll need to add this repository to your apt sources list, otherwise your apt installation won't be able to find the Docker packages. Begin by updating your existing package list and installing some dependencies for the following steps. The CA certificates, curl, GPG, and LSB release tools will be used to download the correct Docker apt repository details and the signing key for your system. Although you've probably already got these packages, it doesn't hurt to make sure that they're available. Next, register Docker's GPG keyring with apt. This will let apt validate the Docker packages you install. The curl command downloads Docker's GPG key for Ubuntu, converts it back to standard OpenGPG encoding, and saves it to apt's keyring directory. chmod is used to set the permissions on the keyring file so that apt detects it reliably. Now you can add the Docker package source to your system. Run the following command. This uses shell substitution to automatically detect your system's architecture, such as AMD64 or ARM64, and download the appropriate package list. It will be verified using the GPG key added earlier. The repository is added as a new package list inside the apt directory. Update your package lists again so apt knows the Docker packages exist. Now you can use the apt install command to add Docker's components to your system. You'll be installing the latest version of Docker Community Edition, or CE. The official Debian package is simple to set up, but you'll have to manually download and install each new release. Packages are hosted on a simple file server. First, navigate to Docker's Release Notes page to find the latest available version number, such as 2010.20. Next, head to Containers GitHub page to check its version number 2. It will be something like 1.6.8. Now you can run the following sequence of commands to download the right set of packages for your platform. Replace Docker version and containered version with the current Docker and containered version numbers, respectively. You can also download the files and inspect all the available releases by visiting the directory listing for your Ubuntu version in your browser. Once you've downloaded the Docker CE, CLI, and containered packages, use the following command to install them. Adjust the file names if you've manually downloaded the packages without using the script already provided. Docker's convenience script automates the installation of all Docker components. It's non-interactive, so you can sit back and wait while your system is prepared for you. First, download the script. Now run the script with root privileges. Wait until the script reaches completion. You should see a confirmation message showing that Docker is installed. The script is meant to be a one-size-fits-all solution. You can't customize what it does without directly modifying the script source. It also isn't designed to perform Docker updates, as it won't bring dependencies up to their latest versions. Whichever installation method you used, you should ensure everything's working by starting a container. You'll see the Docker client pull the Hello World image to your machine from the Docker Hub repository. A new container will then start automatically. The Hello World starter image is configured to run a simple command that outputs some basic information about Docker and then immediately exits. Seeing this output shown means Docker is ready to use. The daemon successfully pulled the Hello World latest image from Docker Hub and started a container using it. Everything from the Hello from Docker line onwards was emitted by the process inside the container. A fresh Docker engine installation usually requires root privileges to run Docker CLI commands. You need to prefix each command with sudo, which is inconvenient. You can avoid this requirement by adding yourself to the Docker group after you've installed Docker Engine using the previously stated steps. This optional change gives you the permissions to run Docker commands as a regular user without sudo, which simplifies your CLI experience. Make sure the Docker user group exists. Then add yourself to it. If you've previously run any Docker command with sudo, you'll need to fix the permissions on your Docker directory. This ensures your own user account is allowed to read and write files in the directory. Log out of your system and back in again so that your new group membership takes effect. Try running a Docker command without sudo. This post-installation step completes the Docker on Ubuntu setup process. The daemon's already configured to start automatically, so you don't have to manually set up a service. If you're planning on an advanced installation, refer to the Docker user manual for instructions on how to configure customized networking, logging, and volume storage management. Docker Compose is a popular Docker companion tool that makes it easier to work with applications that use multiple containers. While the Docker CLI only targets one container with each command, Docker Compose can start and stop several containers with each action. This simplifies managing systems where you've got separate front-end, back-end, and database services. Docker Compose is now available as part of the Docker CLI. The Compose version 2 plugin is included when you use the official installation script to install Docker. It's also available in-app if you used that method. Alternatively, you can download the latest Deb archive and install it manually. Check that Compose is working by trying the Docker Compose version command. While Docker Engine is restricted to a CLI-only experience, Docker Desktop provides a graphical management interface, built-in Kubernetes support, and optional third-party extensions that can help simplify your container workflows. It's a great choice when you're seeking ease of use at your own workstation. To install Docker Desktop, first install some dependencies using apt. Next, run the following set of commands to add Docker's apt repository. Although Docker Desktop is not included in the repository, packages within it are referenced as dependencies by Desktop's Debian archive. The curl command downloads Docker's GPG key for Ubuntu, converts it back to standard OpenGPG encoding, and saves it to the apt keyring directory. Changemod is used to set the permissions on the keyring file so that apt detects it reliably. Download the Docker Desktop Debian Archive from the link in the documentation. This will provide the latest stable release of Docker Desktop for Linux. Use apt to install a package, substituting in the version number you downloaded. Docker Desktop will now show up in your app launcher. Use your launcher to start Docker Desktop and open the UI. You'll be able to run Docker, Docker Compose, and kubectl commands in your terminal too. The application also adds a menu to your shell tray that shows the current Docker Desktop status and lets you perform some quick actions. You'll be prompted to accept a service agreement the first time you run Docker Desktop. Press the Accept button if you consent, and wait while Docker Desktop starts its virtual machine. After a few moments, the dashboard will load. It provides shortcuts to create new containers from popular images, avoiding lengthy terminal commands. Specialized solutions built atop Docker's foundation provide an even easier experience for specific technologies. DevKinsta is a free local development tool for building WordPress themes and plugins that uses Docker to fully isolate and secure your WordPress sites. It makes it quick and simple to start and customize a new WordPress project without setting up servers yourself. Once you're ready, you can push directly to the Kinsta platform to deploy your live site. You can install DevKinsta on Mac OS, Windows, and Ubuntu. Looking for a quality local development solution? With DevKinsta, in a single click, you can design, develop, and deploy new WordPress sites from your local machine. Plus, it's 100% free to use, even if you aren't a Kinsta customer. Download it today at kinsta.com/devkinsta. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.